Hello everybody, today I'm going to show you how to make a necklace to go with these earrings. And it's very easy. If you haven't done these earrings, I'm going to put a link so you can just click on it and go and make them too. Okay, so I'm going to be using beads this size, and you should have them in your thread already, and you're gonna need about 135 depending on how long you want your necklace. I'm gonna do 15 clusters for mine. We're gonna call this a cluster, and you need 9 small beads per cluster. So just do the math. I hope I didn't confuse you. And also you're gonna need bigger size beads to go in between. Last time we used them to go on the top, but this time we're gonna use them to go in between the clusters. And I'm only gonna put 2, but you can put 3 in yours if you want. So I'll be using, oh, and you're also gonna need a clasp, okay? And I'm gonna be using needle size 5 and Lydia's 100% cotton size 10 thread. Okay, and of course your scissors. Let me move my tablecloth, and we're gonna start by threading our needle. Let me find my thread, and this is very easy. You do not, it's just so easy, it's not even funny. It's so easy, and it looks beautiful, I think. You're gonna need, for this project, you're gonna be cutting your thread a lot. So you wanna leave about 6 inches per cluster. So, okay, let's get started. So we're gonna do, for the first ring, we're gonna do, and you're also gonna need, sorry, before I forget, I use this see-through thread, plastic thread for lanyards, but you can use anything to help you with the beads, and I'll be showing you right in a little bit what I mean. Let's see, we're gonna do 5 double stitches. Oh, hold on, I'm sorry, I'm gonna put in my clasp in. Mine is pretty big, so I believe it will go over my beads, so I don't have to count my beads to put them in where I want them to go. I think it goes over my beads. Maybe not. Huh. Okay, never mind. I'll pull it out. But if you're gonna use your a different clasp and the opening and that is not that big, you wanna put it on after the first bead, because that's what we're gonna be putting our clasp. So I'll figure out how to do it right now, because I didn't plan for that right now. Okay, so let's see, 5 double stitches. Okay, and then 1 bead. Let me pick up my thread. Five double stitches. Okay, this is where we need to put our clasp. And I'm gonna figure out how to put it on right now. I think I see an opening right there. But like I said, if you're using a different kind, you can just put it after that, you know, the first bead you put it in, and then you put your clasp in. Come on. And I apologize for that. I wasn't. Let me open it with my teeth, just so you can see it. Okay, so I opened it with my teeth, and I'm just gonna put it there. I don't know if you can see it. And then I'm gonna close it with my teeth again. Okay, so I put it on. Okay, and now you're gonna need 5 double stitches. And 1 bead. Five double stitches. Okay, so this is what we have so far. And we're gonna close our ring. And we're gonna reverse our work. Sorry. You know what? No, we're not reversing our work. I'm sorry. Sorry. We don't reverse our work. Sorry about that. It's just the same as we did the earrings. Okay, let's do, we're just gonna put our needle there. And let's do 7 double stitches. Okay, and then we're gonna need 1 bead. And 7 double stitches. And 3 beads. Seven double stitches. More bead and 7 more double stitches. Okay, so now we're gonna close our ring. Go under the loop. Make a knot at the top. And you're gonna do 1 more ring. We're now reversing our work. 5 double stitches. 1 bead, 5 double stitches, and this is where we're gonna use, we're gonna do something different. You're gonna leave a medium size picot, just like that, and 5 more double stitches. Okay, and 1 more picot, bead, or picot if you're doing picots instead of beads, and 5 more double stitches. Okay, let's close our ring. Just like that. Make a knot at the top. Do another extra knot. Okay, so this is what we have so far. Now at this point you're gonna cut your thread, leave enough so you can weave in your thread, and if you can see, it's a little not stained, but right now when we put our next cluster, it will stay better. And also when you weave in your ends, you can weave in your ends through the bottom ring like this, and it will help it stay up better too. So let me show you real quick. So I just weave in my tails to the bottom ring. Sorry, it got tangled. I don't know why today my thread is not being nice to me. Okay, so I weave in my tails to the bottom rings, to the bottom ring, and you see that? It just stay a little better, stay up a little better, it's not so. And the other one, you can weave it to the other ring, and that will help it too. So let me see if I can do it real quick. I didn't want to take this much time on weaving the thread, but I want to show you that that helps. Just gonna, so one tail is, it's down here, and we're gonna put the tail on the other side. Let me thread my needle. Real quick. Okay, so I thread my needle, and like I said, I went into the other ring just like this, and that helps it stay there a little better. And you can go back over one stitch and go back so it's more secure, but I'm gonna just do it like this real quick because I don't want to be taking too much time. So I'm cutting my tails real quick. And this is our piece so far. We have our clasp on one side and our picot on the other side. So we're going to start a new cluster. like I said, we're gonna call them clusters. And let me thread my needle. It takes a little bit of time to do this necklace, but I think it looks very pretty. And I'm sorry I don't have one in front of me. I forgot that I gave it away to somebody, so I don't have it anymore. So again, we're gonna leave, let me move my beads. We're gonna leave a tail of 6 inches, and we're gonna do 5 double stitches. One pico. Sorry, my table clock is falling off. 5 double stitches. And we're gonna do a pico. We can, you know what, let's join right now. I think we can do that right now. You can, okay, put your work down. And this is where we're gonna use our big beads. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put the beads in top of the pico. And this little piece of see-through thread, or whatever you wanna call it, is gonna help me. So you see how, okay. So I'm gonna grab the beads and put them inside here. That's one. Two. You can do three if you want. I'm just gonna do two. Okay. So there's the beads, and I'm just gonna push them down on top of that pico that we left. And I'm just gonna pull it so a little bit of the pico comes on top of the beads. Just like that, okay? So now we're gonna grab our needle with the work, and we're gonna join to that, to that little piece of pico coming out of those beads. So what I do is I hold my beads on my left, and then I kind of hold it with this finger down so I can have this loop right here. And I can go in that loop. You gotta just make sure you go inside the loop. See that? Just like that. So we're gonna join. At this point, you can take the see-through thing out, or whatever you use. But that, I love using that. It just helps me a lot with the beads. So now we're gonna join. Just be careful you don't lose that loop. And it's not a very easy join. Okay. Okay, now slide it all the way close to your work, just like that. Now we attach our previous cluster to the rest of our work. 5 double stitches. Pico. And 5 more double stitches. Okay, so this is what we have so far, right here. Okay, now let's close the ring. Okay, like that. Remember, we're not gonna reverse our work, and we're gonna make our next cluster with 7 double stitches. Okay, now we need one bead. 7 double stitches. And I have a hair on my work. Happens sometimes. Now we need 3 beads. Okay. And 7 double stitches. Make sure that my bead looks the way I want them to look. Okay, so 2 double stitches, 5 more. Okay, so we got 7, 1 bead. 7 double stitches. Okay, let's close this ring. There's my loop. Okay. We're not gonna reverse our work. And our third ring, 5 double stitches. B. Five double stitches. And medium size pico. This is gonna be our pico where we put our beads, big beads. 5 double stitches. And 1 bead. Five double stitches. Okay, close our ring. Make a knot. And you can make this necklace hard with some glue and water, and it will stay put better too if you like. But once it sits on your neck, it's kind of, you know, it stays like that. So this is what we have so far. See, it's just little clusters at a time. You're gonna have to keep cutting your thread. Right, I'm gonna do one more with you, and then you can continue until you have your length that you want. So we're gonna start another cluster. Okay. Okay, so let's do 5 double stitches. One beat, 5 double stitches, okay, now we're going to put our needle down and pick up our previous work. We're gonna add our beads. There's a big fly flying around in here. I'm wondering if you can hear it in my video. Okay, so we're gonna grab the beads. 1. Slide them down and pull a little bit so we get that loop on the top. I'm gonna go around my finger. You can see that loop right there. Okay, I'm gonna pick up my needle now with my work and go inside that loop. Just be patient, you get in there. Okay, so I'm in. Gonna remove that see-through piece. I'm gonna put my thread behind, my bow thread, so I can join. Like that. Okay, don't lose that loop. It's kind of hard. Oops, I did not do it. You can use those little hoops. Hook. They have small hooks, and it actually helps join. I personally never used one before. I just like to keep trying until I do it. So I did it. Now 5 double stitches. One beat, 5 double stitches, okay, so this is what we have so far. Let's close our ring. There is our loop. We're now reversing our work. Okay. Okay. Next ring. 7 double stitches. Pico, not pico, I'm sorry, bead, or pico, 7 double stitches, three beads, 7 double stitches. Okay, one more beat, and 7 double stitches. Okay. So we have all our stitches, and we're going to close our second ring of this little cluster. There's my loop. Sorry, sometimes it turns around, has this mind of its own. Okay. Like I said, they kind of move around, but once you thread those, wiggle in those tails, and you can harden it too. But like I said, once you put it on your neck, you know, you can starch and put it on your neck, and then it will sit there flat. So don't worry about it so much if it starts not looking right now. So 5 double stitches, and this will be the last cluster I do with you. Because I don't want to bore you with me talking. And 5 double stitches. And we're gonna have our medium pico, right? So every time we have a third ring in our cluster, we have to have that middle-sized pico for our big beads. So 4 more double stitches, bead. And 5 more double stitches. Okay. You see that it's not twisting. Sometimes that happens. And it's kind of hard to see with the camera in front of me. So, bear with me. Okay, good. Little knot. Another knot. Okay. So, this is what we have so far. And it's coming along. Pretty good, fast too. It's not that hard and not that this one twisted. I can see it. Come on, here you go. There you go. I think so. Just be careful with your stitches that your rings. There you go. Just look at them and flatten them and starch them. Oh, sorry, I'm all doing all that stuff without you looking. So as you can see, it's the same thing as our earring. Okay, so continue doing that, and now I'll meet you at the end. I believe I'm gonna make 12, so 3 down, 9 more to go. Have fun tatting. I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, so I'm back. I did 11 clusters for my necklace, and that's, for me, that's big enough. If you have a skinner neck, you want to do less, or if you want it longer, then you can do more. But this is what we have so far. So I'm gonna do my last cluster, and what I did is I added my clasp, and then I added one bead after that, so it's in the order I need it. So you can do that at the beginning of your, you know, your necklace. Okay, so let's do, let's see, let's start with 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it was 4. Actually 5, right? Okay, so let's do 5 double stitches. And then let's add that bead. Okay, 5 double stitches. And let's join. No, we're not joining. I'm sorry. No, we're not joining. We put in our clasp. Sorry. Clasp, 5 double stitches. Bead. And you know, you can join now, you can do your clasp at the end. I'm just gonna do it now because the way I put my beads in. So 5 double stitches. Okay. So we have this now. Let's close our ring. Good. Let's now reverse our work. Let's do 7 double stitches now. And 1 bead. Okay, and 7 double stitches. And we need 3 beads. 7 double stitches. One more bead for this ring. And 7 double stitches. Okay, closing the ring. Under the loop. Okay, a little knot. Okay, so now I'm gonna do my beads, my big beads. Okay, so I'm gonna put my beads in. Like I said, you can do it in any order you want, but this is the order I want to work because of the clasp. Okay, so I'm adding my two beets. Okay. And I'm gonna put it down and do the other ring. So 5 double stitches. One bead, 5 double stitches, and now we're gonna join 2 our beads over here. Let's see. Try not to pull too hard. It's because we don't want our ring to shrink. There you go. And let's join. Like to hold it with my nail so I don't lose it, and this is a little tricky, but you can use a hook, crocheting hook, to help you to join. And 5 double stitches. One bead and 5 more double stitches. Okay, so we got this so far. We're almost done with this beautiful necklace, and let's just close this ring. I want to lose my tail. Good. Let's do a couple of knots to secure our work. We don't want to lose that, right? 1 knot, 2 knots. There you go. Let's cut our thread. You gotta weave it in and hide the tails. And here is our beautiful necklace. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope it was easy for you to follow. Please don't forget to subscribe and comment and like this video. And if you have any suggestions for any tutorial, or you have any questions, please feel free to contact me and send me a message. Thank you so much for watching, and happy tatting.